Good morning, and can I welcome everyone to this, the 15th meeting of the Standards, Procedures and Public Appointments Committee. Our agenda today starts with a decision on whether or not we are going to take item 4 in private. Are the committee agreeable to take item 4, which is a discussion about the committee's business going forward in private? Excellent. I'm grateful for that. Our second agenda item is indeed to welcome Karen Adam, MSP, a potential convener of a new proposed cross-party group on fisheries and coastal communities. Can I welcome you to the committee this morning, Karen? Would you like to explain to us what the purposes and intent behind this proposed CPG are?
Thank you and good morning to the committee. So, as part of my opening statement, I really want to get across the importance of our fisheries to our country and to the economy as a whole. Our fisheries and wider blue economy are an essential part of Scotland's economy and culture. The seas and shores are a part of the rich tapestry of Scotland's history. And as a representative of a coastal constituency, I know firsthand the important contribution that fisheries and coastal communities make to Scotland. And as much as I love to boast about Banffshire and Buchan Coast, if anybody's a bit of a statistician, I have some stats for you here that 48% of constituencies in the Scottish Parliament are coastal, 60% if you include estuaries, and all but one of the electoral regions in the Scottish Parliament touch the coast. So that means there are 93 members of the Scottish Parliament representing coastal communities, including estuaries. That's 72% of our Parliament. And we know from recent debates, both within and out with this place, that the policies affecting fisheries and coastal communities are matters of great importance and have been highly politically sensitive. Scotland boasts the United Kingdom's largest fishing port and Europe's largest white fishing port. Our fisheries and wider blue economy are rapidly evolving, and it's abundantly clear that our food and drink sector, particularly our seafood sector, play a leading role in supporting Scotland to thrive at home and abroad. On a local level, the opportunities that fishing provides are invaluable, from catching to processing and from packing to marketing, and our blue economy offers huge opportunities in abundance. Now, the Scottish fish sector is essential also to brand Scotland and is a key component of Scotland's soft power on the world stage. So there are a number of issues facing fisheries and coastal communities. We have climate change, the spatial squeeze with offshore and inshore renewable energies, and restrictive policies on fishing. And these are just some of the issues that we hope to look at cross-party lines, and I hope the Standards Committee will approve this vitally important cross-party group.
Excellent. Thank you very much, Karen. I hope you're open to questions from the committee. And if it's all right, I'd like to kick off. Firstly, this is not specifically in relation to your application, but you will be aware from your own inbox and your own involvement in other CPGs how many there are in existence at the moment. And there's certainly been evidence that this committee has seen that some CPGs have struggled to maintain the cross-party nature of it and indeed to manage to comply with the requirements of meetings, posting minutes and agendas of that and giving notice. Are you confident, because I know in the papers there's a consideration that there may be support by way of a secretariat, but are you content as the prospective convener, if so elected, to take on that responsibility?
Yes, absolutely. And I do have the support of the Fishmongers Company, who are going to provide a secretariat at, who are based in Edinburgh, from a company called Pagoda. And they also provide that for the all-party group at on the fisheries all-party group at Westminster as well. Also to say, I am on a few CPGs, but the nature of this one, I feel for myself, over the last 2.5 years, as I've been a new parliamentarian embedding in, I have found gaps where I need to have conversations, where there needs to be a forum that certain industries can come together and I can talk cross-party as well, where it's a bit more of a politically neutral position where we can really get to the crux of important issues and, you know, kind of bash that out and get some action points. So I think this is really going to enhance my work and not add to the workload. I feel that this is really going to support my already ongoing work and other MSPs that have come forward to want to join.
That's very helpful. And actually, you articulate one of the important elements of cross-party groups, which is the opportunity for MSPs who are responsible for creating them, obviously, and running them, but to meet with people outside of this parliament to talk about it. Other than the secretariat, there's no mention of non-MSP members of the group. Are you able to update the committee
Yes.
on what that will be?
So I've had some conversations, and I can list a few. Besides the Fishmongers Company, the Scottish Inshore Fishermen's Trust, Scottish Fishermen's Federation, Offshore Wind, a number of individual fishers as well, the Salamander Offshore Wind Project, SSE, Peterhead Port Authority, and representatives of community groups. It's quite a vast array of different industries, but I feel that that's why I wasn't wanting it to be just a fisheries CPG. I wanted it to expand to coastal communities because of all the pressures that are really affecting them at the moment.
That's very helpful. Do any other members of the committee have any questions? Evelyn, if I come to you first and then...
Thanks, Convener. And thank you for your presentation, Karen. That was really helpful. Obviously, there's a lot of commercial interest in this area, and you mentioned yourself that, you know, you are going to maybe cover, if you get approval, politically sensitive policy areas. How are you going to ensure that the CPG isn't co-opted by commercial interests?
Yeah, and that's a really important point, and that's actually a point that some individual fishers have spoke to me about, is the agenda behind some of the memberships on the CPG and how that would affect everything. And I think as convener myself, I would really have to be attuned to that and ensure that we are keeping true to what this cross-party group is meant to be, and it's meant to be supporting the coastal communities and the fisheries and ensuring that their voices are heard above all. Lived experience is something that I always go on about, and this is something that I'll definitely be highlighting and giving most voice to on this CPG.
Thanks, Gavin.
Stephen, did you have...
Karen, the it seems astonishing, doesn't it, that there hasn't been a cross-party group for fisheries in coastal communities up until now.
Yes.
In relation to your experience over the last couple, 2.5 years, are there any of the existing APGs that you've tried to raise these issues in? What's your experience been?
I haven't really found a forum for that. I have looked, because over the last 2.5 years, obviously within my constituency work, but also my work on rural committee, we did once have a round table with the different fishers from the pelagic sector, from processing, from inshore fisheries, and it was really beneficial to have that, but we've only really had that in that moment. You appreciate how packed our workloads can be, and I just felt that we needed that additional space to give room for more to come forward. They kept speaking about, so the fisheries sector kept talking about the renewables industry and the impacts upon ports and you know, service vessels, and I thought there isn't that joined up or collaborative approach it. Some offshore wind companies have had discussions with fisheries, but it's done in bits and parts. And I think having a national overview of that, I think we can really set a standard for best practice of communication between all the industries.
Mm. Thank you for that. As I say, it's quite amazing there hasn't been one up until now. So anyway.
Found the elusive missing.
Yeah, sure, so we've got all these...
All these CPGs, and there's still
then
areas.
Something as obvious as this.
Yeah,
absolutely. Yeah. Does any other member have any questions? Right. If not, can I thank you, Karen, for your attendance today?
Thank you so much.
The committee will consider recognition as its next stage, and the clerks will be in touch with you in due course. But can I thank you for your attendance today?
Thank you, everybody. Thank you.
Well, agenda item 3 is as anticipated, to decide whether or not we will grant recognition to the proposed cross-party group on fisheries and coastal communities. Do any members want to make any comments? Stephen, if I come to you first.
So as a member representing Central Scotland, I have to be honest that fisheries has not always been top of my inbox or casework. agenda, but I would just repeat again, convener, that this is a vitally important, totemic, in fact, part of Scotland's economy, in the fact that we haven't had a cross-party group that looks at this specifically. It seems extraordinary to me, and therefore, as you can probably tell, yeah. I'm very sympathetic to it. But it does highlight the fact that of the 17, however many there are, cross-party groups there are clearly still gaps in terms of the kind of interest there is outside of Parliament for engagement with parliamentarians in that kind of an environment to talk about issues free of the dramas, the dramas of the chamber.
No, I mean, I think that's very helpful, and I think it was very helpful for Karen Adam, MSP, to highlight specifically groups that would be interested in contributing to it, and I think it did show a wide range, and I found it quite helpful that she indicated it wasn't simply fisheries but was also talking about the communities, which was helpful. Do any other members have any? Annie, if I can come to you.
I was just quite amazed with the statistics she was saying about how many MSPs actually represent coastal communities.
Yeah,
yes. And I think that in itself gives warrant to the fact that this is a CPG that is yeah. needed. So that's all I've got to say, convener.
That's yeah. helpful. Ivan, Evelyn, I come to you.
Thanks, convener. Yes, I think Karen's answers about who would be involved, the sort of breadth of the groups that would be involved, I think that was good to hear. I still possibly have a bit of concern about the commercial mm-hmm. interests and how potentially they might try to dominate, as sometimes they do on CPGs. However, I think Karen's aware of that. She talked about the politics of it. So I'm content.
Yeah, Ivan, any comments
to add? Clearly, I need for it, and she's clearly thought about the different aspects and understands what's required, so I'm supportive of it.
That's helpful. Just before I formally put the question then, I mean, one of the things that has concerned this committee, and I think, you know, Stephen, you've made mention of it, is the number of CPGs that exist and the workload that provides or puts on MSPs and the obligations that they have, and we will return to that in relation to the annual report on CPGs to look at the state of all of the CPGs that have existed. But Karen clearly indicated an understanding of the obligations that she was taking on, which I found helpful. So, as a committee, are we prepared to officially recognise the proposed CPG that was before us today, that's been presented by Karen Adams, to make it an official cross-party group?
Yes.
We are. We are in agreement. I'm grateful for that. I will now move this meeting into private.